Hi there, this is Kishore. So this time we are going to speak about Azure Knowledge Gap services. In the previous videos you would have seen about network drive, file share and even a lot of topics with Azure. And now we are going to see something called Azure Knowledge Gap service. Let me get into the portal first. An Azure Knowledge Gap service is like an application which you create. Let us say like you want to create an application that is going to perform a certain set of tasks. You have to sit and write a set of code for that so that it will get executed. The same way, the Knowledge Gap service is also an application that can be created right from your web portal, that is right from your Azure portal. There you can create your Knowledge Gap without writing any piece of code. You can just set your matrices like what you want, what type of conditions you need, and like let us say like you want to keep an if condition, you can set a if condition without writing code. So this is how you can set all the requirements which you need for a set of activities that has to be done without writing any code and execute that program right from the Azure portal. Let me show you a simple example. Consider your Facebook and Twitter. I want the tweets in my Facebook to get shared into my, sorry, tweets in my Twitter account to get shared into my Facebook profile. For that, I can create a Knowledge Gap where it will get authenticated with both my Facebook and Twitter accounts and share all the tweets in my Twitter account to the Facebook. So this can be done. I can do this with the help of Azure Knowledge Gap. For creating a new one, go to new. And in there, web/mobile and Knowledge Gap. As usual, give your Knowledge Gap a name, a location and everything. So let this be Twitter. This is available. Let me create a new one. One sec. So the new name will be Logic App. I mean the resource group name will be Logic App. And let it be South India. Sorry. Where is that South India? One sec. South India, I got it. So let me pin it to the dashboard, create. Let this get created. So it has got created. Now you have just created a Knowledge Gap service, but still you didn't design anything or still you didn't code anything for a set of activities. For that, initially when you create a Knowledge Gap, a Knowledge Gap designer like this will get loaded. For instance, if you have created a Knowledge Gap service, but when you open it again, you will be redirected to your Azure homepage. Okay, so if you want to design a new one, click on this Knowledge Gap designer. This will again load you the same page. So no need of worrying about where my designer page is. Now, come down and you can find a lot of templates in here. You can go for when a new tweet is posted, when a new mail is issued in Outlook. So there are a lot of activities in here. You can choose any number of templates which are matching your requirement. Or you can click on a blank Knowledge Gap and you can directly create a workflow, or you can sit and code. You can do that. Now coming down, let me choose something called Facebook to Twitter. Yeah, here it is. Share my tweets on Facebook. This means, actually, this is a template where the tweets in the Twitter will be shared directly into the Facebook. So let me use this template. And remember, whenever you go to this page, sometimes the save button in here will not be enabled. At that scenario, be careful that if it is not enabled, do not sign in or do not do anything in here. If you do so, you will not be able to save your app. And again, you would be able to, I mean, and again you should discard it and again design the workflow. So be careful about it. I'm clicking on sign in. Since I have already signed in with my Twitter and Facebook, I just need to authenticate it. So if you didn't sign in, you will be asked. So it is asking me to sign in. So this is how you will be doing. Let me give my username and password. Yeah, now remember me, authorize app. The same way you should sign in with your Facebook too. Once you authorize, you provide permission for your Azure app service to access the data and your personal details or whatever it is in that location, I mean in that Twitter account. The same way, let me sign in with my Facebook too. This authentication, it is for providing access for your both accounts. Still, you didn't create any app, any coding or any sort of logic in this. After this, click on continue. Now you will be creating it. Let us say like, so listen, here, how often do you want to check for items? This is for setting an interval like, let me check my items for every 2 seconds, every 1 minute, something like that. The same way, this is interval, like when I select every seconds, it will go for 3 seconds once. Let me choose it as 10 seconds. And here, search text, select, like there is like searched text item like happy or something like this. So let me have a tweet like Azure Logic App Service. I have selected something like this. Now let me copy it as a reference so that I'll not forget it. Copying it. And now, I'm not going to change anything here anymore. Now coming to this one. Direct, what I have set is like, I want to post it, that's it. So the same way the parameters like what I want to post. Tweet or show advanced options. Click on this. You will be asked, it will be shown set of, I mean the body of the tweet, that I mean the post which is going to be posted in your Facebook profile. You can change the body, or if I want to add something in here, click on this and you will be shown n number of options like description, location. You can add anything you want. Let me add the name tweeted by. So in this format, the tweet is going to be shared to my Facebook profile. Now I'm going to save. If you want to add something like some sort of conditions or something, you can click on add an action. You can choose actions in here. Or if you don't want, click on cancel. And if you want some other thing, you can add a condition like an if or else or something like that. Or let me cancel this. I don't want any condition. So let us delete it. Or you can delete it. So I'm deleting this. Or you can even go for more like switch case for each, add a do until, add a scope, something like that. Now This is enough for me. Let me save this. And that's it. You have created an application. You can view your code. You have seen with your eyes. I didn't sit and return any code in here. Just I was setting the workflow. But now the code has been generated in here. This is what I was telling. Like we don't want to sit and code anything. Everything will get coded. All our work is to design the workflow. Now, let me run my application and that's it. Successfully check the trigger. So for every 10 seconds the trigger is going to be happen. So it is going on and on and on. Now let me, so to see your work now, create a new tweet. Let me get into my Twitter account. Let me log in. And here we go. Let me paste the tweet which I have previously selected. I'm testing it and okay, let me tweet it. Meanwhile, let me go to my Facebook. Let me log in there and you can look at this. The trigger is getting on and on and on for every 10 seconds. So it is continuously going on. Now, I am going to my Facebook. There, let me go to my profile. Now my profile is empty. Like, there is nothing except the things which I have tweeted or posted. But what happens is, when this gets triggered and when it finds something which aptly matches my logic app, it will automatically share all the tweets. It'll take some time, but you can see it after. When you do this, let that application be running for 1 hour, and after that you can find lot of tweets flooding into your profile. Last time when I have tried this, what happened is my profile was completely filled with more than 300 posts that are based on tweets in Twitter. So you can find that the tweet is, the logic app is continuously getting triggered on and on and on. So this is how you use a Twitter logic app for sharing your posts. You can try this for yourself and you will find the tweets getting shared in your Facebook profile. So go for a try. You can do it, and at last you will find lot of tweets flooding into your profile. And that is the end of the session for today. Coming back to this, and you can find me in the C Sharp Corner with the name of Kishore Chowdhury itself, and I am C Sharp Corner MVP 2. And that is all for today. We'll get back to you soon with one more logic app service. Thank you.